Bitcoin has soared in popularity in recent years and has pulled along with it the entire cryptocurrency market. Most people begin their crypto journey with Bitcoin and eventually find their way to Ethereum. While Bitcoin is indeed a novel technology that promises to radicalize the finance sector, Ethereum's use cases completely dwarf Bitcoin's. If Bitcoin is like email, Ethereum is like the entire internet.
Today, we're going to explore Ethereum and understand how smart contract platforms like it are powering a wave of decentralized applications. Before we proceed, hit the subscribe button if you're interested in topics like this.
Let's start by trying to understand what Ethereum is. Ethereum is a general-purpose blockchain platform that allows code to run on a decentralized network of computers. Most programs on the internet run on centralized servers, hosted by the likes of AWS and Microsoft. Perhaps the most innovative aspect of Ethereum technology is that it allows code to be executed in a completely decentralized manner without any centralized servers. Software programs running on a decentralized network like this are called decentralized applications, or dApps.
Ethereum was invented by Vitalik Buterin in 2013 when he was only 19 years old. He was inspired by Bitcoin, but believed that the blockchain technology behind Bitcoin had a lot more potential than just Bitcoin. 8 years later, Ethereum has a market cap of over $400 billion, and the network is settling trillions of dollars of transactions. Like Bitcoin, the Ethereum network also uses blockchain technology to achieve decentralization. But while Bitcoin only uses it for one application, money, Ethereum allows its blockchain to be used to program any kind of decentralized application through something called smart contracts. A smart contract is a self-executing contract with the terms written in code and automatically executed given some conditions. Self-executing means the code will automatically enforce the contract.
Imagine that you want to place a wager on the results of a soccer match. You could simply write a smart contract that describes your wager and have both parties deposit funds to the smart contract wallet. After the game, the smart contract will automatically check the score and send the funds to the winner, eliminating the need for a trusted middleman. This is a simple example of a smart contract, but these contracts can be used for all kinds of sophisticated applications. Remember the lending and borrowing protocols we mentioned in our DeFi video? Each of those protocols is a smart contract running on the Ethereum network. Similarly, smart contracts can be used for insurance, prediction markets, escrow, identity management, loans, payroll, trading, and a whole lot more. Ethereum also has its own cryptocurrency called Ether, which is used for fees to run the network and pay miners or validators. These fees are called gas fees.
As a general-purpose blockchain, Ethereum provides a programmable base layer blockchain on which other decentralized applications can be built, including compute servers, file storage, DeFi apps, NFTs, stablecoins, and all other kinds of dApps. dApps that are built on the Ethereum blockchain get all the benefits of a decentralized ecosystem without the need to solve the challenges that come with building a blockchain from scratch. Think of the benefits of using AWS instead of building your own web servers, or using electricity provided by the state instead of setting up your own power plant.
One of the use cases on Ethereum that has exploded in popularity recently is NFTs. NFTs, or non-fungible tokens, are unique, one-of-a-kind tokens that can be used to represent ownership of assets like art and collectibles. We'll be making a whole video dedicated to explaining NFTs soon, so be sure to subscribe. Stablecoins are another important application created through smart contracts. These are crypto tokens whose value is pegged to the value of a fiat currency, such as the US dollar. Stablecoins have different mechanisms of ensuring the pegged value remains, but some of the best stablecoin projects, like USDC, Reserve, and DAI, run on the Ethereum blockchain. Stablecoins are a very valuable use case as they come with all the benefits of cryptocurrencies without the risk of volatile prices. Visa, the global credit card processor that processes 150 million transactions per day, recently announced that they would begin settlements with merchants in USDC on the Ethereum blockchain due to its efficiency compared to traditional settlement mechanisms.
One of the biggest criticisms about Bitcoin is the enormous amount of energy its miners use to verify transactions. You might remember from our Bitcoin video that a consensus mechanism is the method by which nodes in a blockchain agree upon the state of the network. Bitcoin uses a consensus mechanism called proof of work, which requires miners to solve complicated math problems to verify transactions in exchange for a block reward. This is a very energy-intensive mechanism because miners are constantly trying to use more powerful computers to win the block reward. Ethereum currently also uses a proof-of-work consensus mechanism, but is transitioning towards a new system called proof-of-stake. In a proof-of-stake blockchain, the validators stake their Ether to verify transactions in exchange for a transaction fee. Instead of competing to solve a math problem, a validator has a probability of winning the block reward proportionately to the amount of the Ether they stake. This approach is more energy efficient and has a lower barrier to entry for validators, which should make the network more decentralized. It also disincentivizes malicious behavior by validators because their staked Ether could be seized. This highlights one of the biggest philosophical differences between Bitcoin and Ethereum. Unlike Bitcoin, Ethereum is an ever-evolving platform. While the Bitcoin code almost never changes, the Ethereum network is constantly being developed and improved by the community. This is one of Ethereum's strengths because its active developer community is constantly helping it evolve and become a greater platform over time.
It's important to remember that since Ethereum is decentralized, no one, not even its founders, have executive control of the platform. However, Vitalik and many others are still actively involved in its development and roadmap. Despite its many brilliant features, Ethereum does have some drawbacks. The biggest one for now is scalability. Ethereum 1.0 can only process about 30 transactions per second. This is something that is being improved, and the next version of Ethereum 2.0 should be able to process 100,000 transactions per second. But for now, Ethereum is seriously suffering from an inability to process the huge volume of transactions of the network. Since the network can only process so many transactions, people have to pay a lot in gas fees to get a transaction through when there is a lot of transaction volume on the network. These days, a simple transaction can cost hundreds of dollars in gas fees, and the code that fixes this is still months away from being released. Other competing smart contract platforms like Cardano, Polkadot, and Binance are rapidly gaining users and benefiting from Ethereum's congestion, as are Layer 2 solutions built on top of Ethereum like Polygon. We'll be making a video about these other platforms too, so smash the subscribe button. In the midst of all this hype around cryptocurrencies, it's important to remember that the price of Ether is still very largely driven by speculation. Despite Ethereum's large user base using the platform for real applications that provide value, the price of Ether is not a reflection of its utility, but more a reflection of market sentiment. In the long run, however, Ethereum's token model should drive up the price if the network continues to see increased usage and adoption.
A common argument pointed out by Ethereum bears is the annual inflation of Ether. Unlike Bitcoin, which has a fixed monetary policy and a finite supply of coins, Ethereum doesn't have a hard cap on the number of tokens in circulation. However, there is a new Ethereum improvement protocol currently in development named EIP-1559 that aims to make Ether a deflationary currency like Bitcoin by burning a small amount of Ether in every transaction. This means that if the demand for the token outpaces the inflation of Ether, the currency should become deflationary as the supply will keep decreasing with more users and more transactions, at least in theory. In spite of its scalability issues, Ethereum is still winning the smart contract wars as it has all the developers and all the projects. Only time will tell which project will win and become the dominant smart contract platform. But for now, Ethereum remains kingpin of the blockchain space. We hope you enjoyed this Lightbulb moment. If you did, please like, subscribe, and comment below to let us know what video you'd like to see next.